We believe that past traumas that you face in your life cannot be fully erased from your mind. Because you would have still needed to face some sort of incident, would have been so brain triggering and nerve biting for that thing to turn into a trauma. So I believe that past traumas at the moment they're the worst thing ever. But as you gradually move on them with life, I think the person gets used to them and can easily adapt his brain to not having to think about or stress about it. You can look at more aspects in life, what's going on with this, like other stuff. You know, like you don't always have to be constantly pressuring yourself on that one incident. You should be able to look at the other aspects in life which you've been given. And I believe that if you keep on looking at past traumas instead of embracing the future, that really affects your mental health in a really way.
Studies, childhood trauma, friends, and mostly the treatment of parents plays the major role in affecting our mental health as we spend the most time with them.
Certain factors contribute to mental health, including biological, psychological, and environmental aspects. Genetics, brain chemistry, and life experiences all play significant roles. Biological factors such as genetics can predispose individuals to certain conditions, while psychological factors like coping skills and personality traits influence mental health. Environmental factors including stressors, trauma, and supportive relationships, and shape mental health. And finally, how do you think mental health issues can be
addressed? My advice for the people who have challenges regarding mental health is, number one, seeking help is very important. You need to be very comfortable and non-hesitant in seeking help from others. You have to keep your close mentors, your advising friends, a positive company around you. You need to be having, even you can pet a good cat or dog, or you can be having any person who is close to you. You can be having a very good hobby that can be decluttering you. For example, painting, singing, anything. And above all is the medical counseling. You need to be consulting the psychiatrist and definitely for a neuro clinician or a neurosurgeon, anyone who can deal with that issue by keeping evidence in front of him. So rather than abiding with the rumors and reading the medical literature from internet, that will increase your anxiety. So you have to consult the right person for the right job. So have a mentor or a good friend around. Second, slow down, go easy on yourself, don't be hard on yourself. Number three, you have to consult a psychiatrist, a person who will be able to resolve your issues.